Okay, Dee. Welcome to this meeting of for the project meeting for projects serial number 15, 16 and 17, in which you are actually going to make a sign board size something using 1206 size SMD LEDs of different colors, and you are going to have three different names written over here. You are going to have Maker's Lab written, and then you have workshop written, and then you have a UET Lahore written, and all of these are in block letters, or in fact capital letters actually. And the PDF file I have shared with you is quite self-explanatory what you have to do over here, but again I'm just going to give you an idea. I'm sharing my screen at present with you so everyone has an idea what this is regarding. So if you see this PDF file, I hope everyone has this thing. In the very start of this PDF file, I've given you the idea that which LED you are using, which SMD LED, 1206 size, has the size of 3.2 mm cross 1.5 mm cross 1.3 mm. So certainly you are going to put this LED in the 3.2 mm size direction, as it is given in your sample picture as well. If you have seen the picture, sample picture, let me just give you the sample picture view again. The sample picture, as you can see over here, so if this is the LED, this is the Nagin LED, not a very good soldering in this project overall, but anyway, this is done over here. The LEDs are in the same direction, that is the 3.2 mm direction over here. So coming back to the PDF file over here, so you are using the 1206 SMD LED, and certainly when you are going to arrange them, you have to write these three words: Maker's Lab, UET Lahore and Workshop. And I have given that you have to use capital letters, okay, or block letters. Better if you use capital letters, because making them in block means that M will be larger, A, K, E, R, S, and then L will be larger, and then A, B will be smaller, or then certainly for the UET Lahore and Workshop. Now, there are some restrictions on this one. The size of the PCB should not be greater than 210 into 297 mm. In landscape mode, this is the A4 size. And then when you are having two SMD LEDs, the distance between them should not be more than 4 mm. By what I mean over here is this, that if you can see over here where my mouse or cursor is at present, if this is one LED, he has placed the other LED here. Now, this is a very large distance. So when this whole word, is, this W is actually going to be seen, you are actually not going to have a continuity of the LED over here. So the light continuity is not going to be there. So the condition of having this 4 mm is necessary. And if you see over here, 1206 size is having a 3.2 mm. And then I have given the condition of 4 mm. So not greater than the width of approximately 4 mm. Okay? And if you want to make it double letters, then you can make it double letters over here as well. By double letters, I mean, supposingly, if this is one LED over here in front of you, and certainly if this is the, there will be a marking on each LED over there. So if this is the anode and this is the cathode, you can have two of the LEDs over here as well. So this is the cathode over here. So this is something like this diode over here. This is just like a light emitting diode over here. So you can have two of them. So this, what this will make when you are going to make supposedly an O, so you are going to make double of these O over here. So this will be bold. Now, I'm not asking you to make it bold, because certainly this will increase the cost as well and your effort as well. But one is significant, but if you want to actually make bold, there is no harm in it. It's not compulsory. It's not compulsory, but you can do it. So use of capital letters is compulsory for each project, and each letter of height 60 mm. So what is this height? This is the height of this M. So the height of M or A or K or UET or Workshop, it has to be 60 mm. Okay? It has to be 60 mm. So whatever LEDs are required. So if this was like supposedly this one was one LED, then there was another LED, then there was another LED, then there was another LED, so then there was another LED. So when you are going to combine all of this, supposedly you were making an eye over here like this, so the whole height of this this one, this should be equal to 60 mm, and the width of this should be, as declared in the PDF file, this should be at least 28 mm. at least 28 mm. If you go to 30 or something, it's totally up to you, because some letters will be small. A, as you can see, is a little bit more in width size, so it's not that it can be 35 or 40 even in some cases, but otherwise there's a restriction that you have to use 60 mm and 28 mm. So apart from these two restrictions, there is no other restriction overall. The color restriction, I've already told you that you have to use the red for section A, green for section B, blue for section C, and white for section D. Now when you are going to use this red, green, blue, and white, they are going to have their own forward voltage drops. Now whenever you are going to buy this one, you have to first of all find out the forward voltage drops over there. So what is this actually going to happen? If supposingly, if I make it over here, let me just move on to the other screen over here. So if I have this LED over here, this is one LED, I have another LED, I have another LED, and I have another LED. Now these are four LEDs in series. I have joined them together and they will be illuminating some of them. I will have to attach a small resistance, and this hole is going to be connected to 12 volts over here. Now, how many LEDs are going to be in series? This is dependent upon the forward voltage drop. For example, just for example, I'm not giving an exact value over here. If you are using a red color, the forward voltage drop of such LED is approximately 1.6 or 1.7 volts. Okay. Now, 1.7 volts, if I have supposedly like, let me just add over here, if this is not the connection. If I can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of these LEDs, 6 into 1.7, that is the total voltage over here, and then there will be some resistance over there. Plus, there is going to be a resistance to limit the current. This is very important. So when you are going to use a resistance, so somehow the current should be equal to, for red one, it should be something equal to like 10 milliamperes or something like this over here. This is very important. Okay? But for each LED, this will be different. So one thing very important, as I have indicated in this file over here, that before designing any PCB, please make sure what forward voltage drop of each LED bought earlier is, and calculate the number of LEDs in series with the resistance value. Now, for example, if I go back to my design over here, which I was doing, if I want a 10 milliampere current, I have a red LED of having a forward voltage drop of 1.7 volts over there. What resistance is I require? I will have a require of R equal to, since I have 12 volts minus over here, since one of the forward voltage drop is 1.7 multiplied by, now here what figure I want to use over here, supposedly that figure is equal to just like 4, for example. Okay, and I divided this one by the amount of current which I require over here, that is 10 milliampere. In this way you are going to calculate the resistance, and the value of resistance that you calculate, if that resistance is near to your standard value, okay, you are already familiar with the standard values available, then you can use this 4. Okay, and if that is not near to your resistance, then maybe you can use 5 over here, and then the resistance value will change. And then certainly if you are using, instead of red, you are using another color, then this current will also change. So that's why I have selected 12 volts over there. So when you are going to work on red, so there will be like 5 LEDs in series. But when you are going to work for green, then will be, because it has going to be a forward voltage drop of something 1.8 or 1.9. Blue is going to have a forward voltage drop of something 2.1 or 2.2. And then there will be white, which is going to have the even the more voltage drop of something 2.5. So maybe for red ones, they are going to be like 4 or 5 of these ones over there. So when you are going to have a picture something like this, as you can see over here, all the resistances are shown over here, not very well soldered over here. We will do that one in front of you in the lab so that you can actually do it. But before that, your PCB has to be on the top layer, and it has to be something like same like this, with all the LEDs arranged in this direction, so that when 1, 2, 3, 4 LEDs are complete, then you will start another one from the 12 volt line. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, then you will start another one. 1, 2, 3, 4, you will start another one. 1, 2, 3, 4, you will start another one. Now at any point, somehow, if the letter distance is very, very small, where my mouse cursor is moving at present, and you have only just like 2 LEDs over there, spaces of 2 LEDs only, then you will have 2 LEDs over there, but the value of the resistance over here, you will increase it. This is very important. ठीक है, सो दैट ऑल द एक्सेसिव वोल्टेज विच यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग दैट इज डिसिपेटेड अक्रॉस द रेजिस्टेंस एंड द करंट स्टिल रिमेन्स इक्वल टू दैट फॉरवर्ड वोल्टेज करंट दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड ओवर दी. ठीक है, सो इन दिस वे यू आर गोइंग टू मेक दिस थ्री डिफरेंट प्रोजेक्ट्स ओवर हेयर, मेकर्स लैब, यूटी लाहौर एंड वर्कशॉप ओवर हेयर, सो दैट यू कैन हैव all of these done. So I hope this is clear from this side. Any questions on this one, please ask. That's not ji. How many students? There are 12 students in the audience, so if anyone has any questions on this one, please first of all see from where you are going to buy this red, green, blue and white LEDs and find out their forward voltage drop. This is very, very important that you find out their forward voltage drop, that what is their forward voltage drop, so that you know what value is required, what is the value of the resistance that is required over here for the total overall. Ji, any questions, ji beta? Any questions for this project? This project very simple, it involves some aesthetics. So the how you actually arrange those letters and how you are going to solder it, that's going to be very important. So the overall appearance of this project is very much important. So when you are going to have this one in something shaped like this, this is how your whole PCB should be looking over here. No IC beta, there will be no IC as such. That's why I'm actually again saying the project is very simple. The aesthetics is important, the overall aesthetics, how you will arrange your letters, they should be of the same width, they should be of the same, and how you arrange them and when they will actually be lighted up, red, green, blue color, and only LEDs and resistors. Yes, beta, circuit diagram is very simple. I guess there is no circuit diagram over here. I guess the message is loud and clear that you just have to arrange LEDs in series in such a way, SMT LEDs, so that you will write down Maker's Lab, Workshop and UET Lahore. Okay? So which color you are using for the SMT LED, the size of SMT LED I have given you, that is 1206. I hope you, all of you have seen some signboards or billboards, something like this, and you have been making this signboards, you have seen this, which are lighted up in different colors, red, green, blue. So each section have, yes, you have to make it on LTM and you have not known, first of all, you have to make it on LTM beta. You have to make it on LED. Yes, basically this project is made up of series of LED. Beta, I have given the name suggestion over here. If you see the text over here, I have given you the sample on page number one of the PDF at the lower bottom. I have given you makers and lab. They are on two different lines. You can see over there. You can see over there in the file that makers and lab, they are on two different lines. No, makers lab are not going to be in the same line. Okay? The size of the LED as given in the PDF file I have shared just above also, this is 1206. Okay. This is only single layer beta, the resistors and everything, they are on the top layer. You can use jumpers or wires, okay, if there is some crisscrossing or whatever, and certainly they will be on the back side coming on. But on the front side, you will just have the layers, that is a top layer. This all project has to be done in top layer because LEDs are going to be fixed on the top layer and they are going to be lighted up. They are going to be visible to you. So resistors will also be there. But don't worry about the aesthetics over there when the resistance is on the top layer, because when it will be lighted up, certainly there will be some black screen or some tinted glass in front of it. So those resistances are not going to be used. Resistance is very much important. Whatever resistances you are using, they should be of 1210 size or 2512 size. 2512 size, if you are using something a 0.5 watt resistor, if you are using for less current, then certainly 1210 resistance is required. So normally if you are having like 4 or 5 or 6 LEDs in series, then certainly 1210 size is enough. But if you are having something like two or three of them in series and you are just using those two or three and the value of resistance is also large, then in that case certainly you will have to move to 25-1-2, because this means that it's going to dissipate more power. So certainly you will require, this is a single layer meter. So basically this is a single layer project and everything is on the top layer. Just make the markation, the keep out layer, according to the size I have mentioned, the size of an A4 size paper, that is 297 into 210 mm. This is the maximum limit. Okay, this is the maximum limit. Don't go beyond this size, because more than this size we won't be able, because this project which we are going to make, I'm not going to ask you to make them, because the cost of the LED is going to be also enough for you. So I'm not going to ask you to make this PCB maybe from Hall Road or somewhere else. Maybe we will manufacture this one in the lab. Yes, we will. You will making this one also. All the projects which are being done this year, since you have not done anything in the physically from the other labs up till now, or other assignments up till now, everything has been done on the software. So this will be done physically. Okay. So, and one thing very important, if your project, I make this announcement again and again. If the project is very good and it is soldered beautifully and it is working, then certainly we can neglect all your performances before this project and give you straight away a very good grade according to you. But again, on the condition that the project is standing out from all the other projects. So maybe at the end of the project, since there will be like 23 projects, and assuming there are like three groups per each project. So maybe we can select like top 5 projects over there and we can give them the best grade, if they are the best, certainly according to some threshold. Voltage, you're just going to give 12 volts and ground, and that is going to be provided by a block connector. There is no regulator, nothing on it. You are just going to provide 12 volts, and that's why I have selected 12 volts, because when you are going to use white LED, they are going to be very small number of LEDs in series, because white takes the most maximum voltage drop. But I can't give you an idea, let me just give you an idea on this one, for those who are skeptical about this, how many LEDs will be in the U letter. If you see this one, I have U over here, okay? And this U, I have told you that this height is 60, this height is 60 mm, and this curvature approximately, this is 60, this is 60, and I have told you that this height, this should be 28 mm. So assuming that this is 28, so how much distance this is? This is 60, 60 and 28. So this comes out to be 148 mm, and I have asked you that each SMD LED is of approximate 3.2 mm, and you can have a distance of 4 mm in between over there. Okay. So this means that if somehow you can maintain a 3.2 plus 3.2 also, 2 mm we have to over here. So this means just divide 148 by 6.4 mm, and this will give you the number of LEDs which are going to be in the letter U. So you will get an idea. These LEDs are not that expensive, don't worry. If you buy in bulk for one LED or whatever, they are just going to be like 1 rupee or 2 rupees, I guess, of maybe reasonable quality. If you go for a better one, maybe 1206 size, then maybe something like 3 or 4 rupees. So even if they're like 200 LEDs over here in this total overall, so maybe if any one LED is like something 30 or one LED is of 3 or 4 rupees, so it's not going to be that much cost over here. Some students are joining late now. Taking the attendance now, so this 14 students are there, so expecting the rest of the 10 are not here. Any questions, Gbeta? Any questions over here? Please, whatever groups you are doing, please first of all see which SMD LED color you are using, find out its forward voltage drop, and then you can find out how many you are going to use in series. Other videos uploaded, beta, they are for the other groups over there. I'm not asking for you to actually. Your project is just this 15, 16 and 17 serial number. So you don't have to worry about the other projects over there. This project is very easy, and I can term this one as the easiest project in the zone. But please involve aesthetics inside this one so that you can have. No, you don't all have to make Makers Lab, UET Lahore, and workshop. Makers Lab is given to one group, UET Lahore is given to one group, and workshop is given to another group. Okay? So don't make them all on one page. That's why I have given in the PDF file, I have given the size over here. If you have seen this PDF file, in this PDF file, you have the Makers Lab 60 mm. So the page is approximately a 210 mm width, this size, the landscape size, the width one over here. So if you are having a 60 mm here, then a 60 mm distance, and then a 60 mm, and then you are leaving 30-30 over there. So certainly this 210 mm can be automatically completed. So certainly UET Lahore and all that, this can be done. So I hope everyone can do this very easily. This is just the aesthetics over there. And in 1 week's time, we will meet again over here and we will discuss these 12 projects, whatever you have done. So after 1 week, whatever problems you will be facing or whatever remedies we will be suggesting over here for this, we will give a 1 or 2 day more, and then we will submit this project over here. But a last date will be communicated to you, but you have 1 week's time from now on. You have all the material with you, you have the PDF file which I have given you the instructions, the sizes and all that stuff. You just have to search on for your LED what is the possible forward voltage drop and the current of your. You can easily Google it out, and maybe from some online website you can even get it. But I will advise you to personally go to Hall Road, or maybe just get the forward voltage drop and the current for each LED. So you have an idea that how many LEDs you are going to connect in series and what will be the value of resistance over here. This lecture is being recorded, so if you have missed any something, so this will be uploaded on the YouTube channel. So don't worry if you have missed something, those who are joining late over here. Gee, any questions from the audience? The project is very simple. I hope this is clear what we expect from you. And please, one thing very important, if you have seen this picture of the last year project, the words O, as you can see over here, they are very congested. W and O and R, they are very congested. And then S, as you can see, it's not even complete. So it's not the very best of it. I am not giving you this one as a sample. I'm just giving you as something what I expect from you. And it should be much, much better than this one. Okay. So this is very important that you have something. And one thing very important, please try have a habit of using fill areas, because the total current which is going to travel over here, he has done a very big problem. This student Adil Hussain and Zishan Aslam over here, they have done a very big problem. This wire has to travel a lot of current, and this should be joined with the fill area. The fill area should be extended up till here, but he has not done it, so this will be a problem. So as soon as you will give supply to this 12 volt and ground, this will be heated up, and maybe the track is actually will be removed. The LED is there, beta. Actually, this is not a very good picture. It's actually just taken from a very, I guess, a mobile. The LED is there already, where my mouse or cursor is hovering at present. You can zoom in the picture. I have shared the picture in your chat over here. Okay. It's of gray color or brown color, if you can just zoom in. Okay. The picture is there. So yes, this is, I hope so you can have a look. This is that where my mouse or cursor is. This is that LED. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 over here. The distance between two LEDs, I have just kept it 4 mm, so that even if a track is going to go towards 12 volt or something, you can actually have it done or routed easily. Gee, any questions with this? So I hope this is clear, and in 1 week's time we will have something from each one of you, and be ready with your forward voltage drops and all that, whatever, how you have calculated it. So maybe 1 week's time we will have another meeting, maybe not at this exactly this time, but something sometime in the evening, maybe next week over here for all your problems over here. And in 1 week's time, I hope everyone can do this. And then after having all the remedies of all your problems, maybe for 3 4 days and added in, we can have the final design and we can give this design for manufacturing. And then when the university opens, we can help you to solder this thing. So maybe when the university opens, maybe we'll have a session, because soldering SMD LEDs is very difficult, as you have seen in this picture. The last year project, the soldering is very pathetic. You have made blobs over here, so it's not a very good soldering. In fact, I will show you how to actually, this comes with some practice. So maybe, and one thing, very problem, this workshop which he has written, this Adil Hussain and Zishan Aslam over here, from 2018 session, A19 was the group name actually. He actually connected anode and cathode in the wrong direction. So this is very important that you don't connect it, because if you connect the LED diode in the wrong direction, it will never work. ठीक है? So just designing the PCB in this project is not the easier, not the difficult work. The difficult way is actually the solder in this project. So designing maybe they're not going to take more than like 1 day or 2 day of you. And since you are 2 persons for each group, I guess you can do half of the words. One person can do half of the words. One person can do. But please make the letters legible, which means that they are actually visible and they have the same width and height as depicted in the rules given in the PDF file. So I hope this is all. I guess there is no questions from the audience now. So I will be just now ending this meeting, and I will be uploading this small video on the YouTube channel. So if you have any queries, you can go through this one again. Any questions, we? I hope so. This is no. Try to have them. LEDs cannot be at any angle. Try to you. I just like I have given you this presentation. So just like this one, if you are trying to make eye, try to make them in the lengthwise. This one. So all the LEDs have to be. So which direction you are going? Oh, beta, 50-50 work is not that difficult. It's not that difficult to do a 50-50 work. It's not that difficult. If you are doing makers lab, makers can be done by you, and the lab can be done by another one, because you just have to make nets over here, and you just have to make it. So you can just exchange the file, PCB doc file, and you can do it very easily. Okay? Yes, resistance will be on top. There is no issue on this one. It's a single layer PCB, top layer. Everything is on the top layer. Just the block connector will be at the back end. Sorry, the actually the other end, and this is the top layer PCB. Yes, the resistances must be on the top. So I hope this is clear, and I hope I have made myself clear that whatever is being done in this project, which I have given in the PDF file. If you see the SMD, I have given the SMD sizes over there, that if you are using a 0.25 watt, that is if you are having 4 or 5 SMD LEDs in series, then you can use 1210 size. But where you have like 2 or 3 only, and then there is a small, and then you will be using a larger resistance, maybe something 1K or 2K, because then you have to have more voltage drop across the resistance, then you will use 2512 size. All of these resistances are available in the same library chip and resistor that you have used already in all the previous assignments submitted up till now. This is single layer. So I hope this is enough, and I hope I have made myself clear. So all of those who are present over here, these 13 people, your attendance has been marked. So hopefully, please, if you can send a message to the other ones who are not here, please be try to do this project. The video will be shared and on the YouTube channel, so you can have a look afterwards again. Thank you.